the second half have at different times been criticized for being overindulgent in their music, particularly Scriabin, whose unashamedly sensuous Poem of Ecstasy ends the concert. But first, the setting by Szymanowski of the religious hymn Stabat Mater Dolorosa. The Polish composer Karol Szymanowski was constantly searching for a personal style. He was always open to exotic elements in literature, philosophy, and the visual arts, and he loved to synthesize these influences into an expressive and very intense musical language of his own. In 1924, the Princess Edmond de Polignac, an extraordinary musical patron and a friend of Poulenc and Stravinsky, commissioned Szymanowski to write a work for solo voices, choir, and orchestra. The death of the composer's niece prompted the choice of the Stabat Mater, the lament for Mary, the mother of Jesus. The words begin, "The mother stood in sorrow, weeping by the cross, while her son was hanging there. A sword passed through her grieving, anguished heart." The commission stipulated a text in Polish. Szymanowski was happy to provide one. In an interview with a Polish music magazine, he said that in its Polish or everyday version, that ancient hymn acquired a peculiar sense of immediacy. It became like a picture painted with familiar colors, in contrast with the drawing of the original. This directness of message was important to a composer keen to reflect the honest, simple faith of peasants, rather than the generalized concepts of religious practice. However, for the benefit of non-Polish performers and listeners, Szymanowski also set the standard Latin text as an alternative, and that's what we'll be hearing this evening. Well, I must say, I was completely knocked out by this piece this morning because I've often heard it on discs, but today was one of the first times I'd heard it in the concert hall, and Esa-Pekka Salonen takes it very coolly. He doesn't milk it. It's quite a quick version of the piece, and somehow it gains stature and dignity for not being over-sentimentalized. Stephen Bryant, the leader of the BBC Symphony Orchestra, returns to the front of the platform. And now we await a very distinguished lineup of soloists, led by the Norwegian mezzo-soprano Brandi Stina. Following her is Judith Howarth, the soprano, and Jason Howard, the baritone, with Esa-Pekka Salonen, who will conduct the BBC Symphony Orchestra and chorus in the Stabat Mater by Karol Szymanowski.
Thank you.
last I have written something really beautiful. Karol Szymanowski's own words on finishing the last movement of his Stabat Mater. And I think he had every reason to feel satisfied. This evening it was performed by Judith Howarth, the soprano, Randy Steiner, the mezzo-soprano, and Jason Howard, the baritone, with Esa-Pekka Salonen conducting the BBC Symphony Orchestra and chorus. Fascinatingly, that music somehow takes something from both the impressionism, though he hated the word, of Debussy, and the expressionism of Scriabin, with whom we'll end the concert. But what a heartfelt piece it is. Here come the soloists once again, Randy Steiner, Judith Howarth, and Jason Howard. And also Stephen Jackson, who the chorus master who trains the BBC Symphony Chorus. And I can tell you, he puts them through their paces. It reminds me a little bit, in its nationalistic fervour, that piece, its almost unstated nationalistic fervour, if you like, of the Janáček Lagolitic Mass. All of these three soloists have got blooming opera careers. Jason Howard had a great success with Opera North in Billibud and Showboat. And he seems to be singing Marcello in every opera house known to man or beast. Interestingly enough, several of these singers are going to Covent Garden soon, and Esa-Pekka Salonen himself will be going to conduct Hindemith's Matti Stamala. Hindemith, another character rather like Szymanowski, not at the forefront of the musical world, but a very, very important figure nonetheless, and one whom we should probably hear more about. Soloists return. Jason Howard, Stephen Jackson, the chorus master, Judith Howarth, and Randy Steiner, the Norwegian mezzo-soprano. Well, this may not be the largest audience of the prom season, but I can tell you it's a damn discriminating one, because this is, in my view, precisely the kind of programme that makes the proms worthwhile. Unusual pieces and new work.